Kendrick Lamar, arguably one of the best rappers to ever exist, with his cinematic, next-level storytelling, visionary ideas, and upper echelon lyricism, has given his fans one of the best representations of spiritual growth through this art form, and I must say that it has helped me a lot with my own spiritual journey.
That was Good Kid, M.A.A.D City album. Question was, why do I put spirituality inside my music? Really, truthfully, you know, it comes from me as a person, you know, somebody that was always inquisitive, you know, on life after this world, inquisitive on God and Jesus himself, you know, always trying to figure out and just become a better person. I'm not saying that I'm an actual saint, you know, but this is me, this is who I am. And people be scared of that, you know. Sometimes the industry was scared of that for a long time, but I couldn't stray away from that. That's how I think on a daily basis, and my music reflect my actual life. So I will always continue, you know, to put that type of message and them type of stories in my music, no matter what I'm doing, because this is me as a person, you know, my personal beliefs. You know, maybe you might not have the same personal belief, but at the same time, you still think, you know, and maybe you can spark an idea in your brain, you know, and continue to keep going, because that's what keeps me going.
Throughout Kendrick's career, it was like he was the prince becoming the king of the kingdom. Kendrick was the golden child, Neo in the Matrix, the successor. He was like Jesus, the savior of hip-hop, and he took this with a badge of honor. Even though it may have been irrational for a rapper, a poet, to be the savior of hip-hop, but furthermore, the savior of the black community. I remember being a child, like 10 years old, when Good Kid, M.A.A.D City first came out. And I remember the first song I ever heard off that album was the Backseat Freestyle. I was hearing it everywhere. And then I listened to it upstairs in like my house. I'm like, damn, I love this song. Like, that's where I really started to fall in love with hip hop. And just because I just love the skill, the precision, the creativity of it. And that was like, from that point forward, I'm like, okay, well, Kendrick Lamar is a name I must remember. Then I got a little older. I started to grow into my teenage years, and my brother was listening to Pimp a Butterfly and stuff like that. And I'm like, damn, who is this dude? And it's Kendrick Lamar. And I'm like, dog. I'm like, and I really started to believe into the narrative that he is like a Jesus type figure, a Christ like figure, coming to save the black community, the rap community. And I was one of the people that took that narrative and really believed in it. Even I believe Kendrick was like a Christ like figure, especially with the way that he always spoke about his messages. So then when this album, Mr. Morale and the Big Steppers, dropped, in my opinion, from what I perceive it to be, I perceive it as a form of Kendrick reaching this form of enlightenment or Christ consciousness. Now, when I tried to listen to this album for the first time, it was a very hard album to listen to, mainly because of how honest, how vulnerable it was, especially when I was going through this type of transformation, this metamorphosis inside myself. It legit took me over a year to really listen to this album. I was going through my own spiritual awakening. It had a lot of topics, were something I was dealing with, and it was like a reflection of me, and it didn't make me feel good at all. So I ran for as long as I could. And eventually I came back to the album to realize that it's actually extremely healing, right? I think when we healing, we try to run away. We want to neglect that healing. We want to run away from us as long as we can. We don't want to accept the fact of our fragilities or things that we may come up short in. And that's all of what this album was. It was like zero boasting in this album. It was just straight raw truth. And it just made me super uncomfortable. So when I finally decided to listen to the album, I realized that it was a very healing album. I realized that it was a very reflective, introverted, self-actualizing album. And as a hip-hop fan that I so dearly was, I wasn't accepting the fact that it was this type of album, because I think, let's be honest, all Kendrick fans at that moment was really just waiting on Kendrick to drop some lyrical shit. Like, we going to some next-level bars, like, literally. Like, and it wasn't that, but one thing I can say was that it was something needed for the culture. In this album, Kendrick Lamar is surrendering. He's letting his guard down. He's done fighting. He is forgiving himself. He's holding compassion. He's taking that step into humility And it's really amazing to see and hear. He starts the album with united in grief, in a state of pleading for help, crying out, stating his grievousness, confession of his imperfection and self-righteousness, to literally coming to the self-realization on choosing himself over the culture and the song Mirror. And my favorite songs off the album is Count Me Out, Crown, Mother I Sober, Auntie Diaries, United in Grief, Mirror, Father Time. But then the whole album, because it's just raw honesty. I remember hearing Count Me Out, and it was giving me vibes of Feel on Damn. It was really just him at his most raw state, saying how he was literally, you know, he's human. Like I said, you know, we all have these emotions, we all have these feelings. Sometimes we want to shut down. Maybe we too workaholics. Maybe we're too judgmental. Maybe we don't open up enough. With Crown, it's just admitting, surrendering to the fact that, like I said, you can't save everybody. You're not meant to save everybody. You can't even save yourself. So why do you think that you can save everybody? And you're supposed to turn inwardly and save yourself, heal yourself. And then he goes to Mother, I Sober, and I'm like, damn. And these feelings of, let's say, just having compassion for the ones that have compassion for you, the ones who always been there for you, your mother, the feminine figures of your life. Just being able to openly express your love and thankful for their struggle, and like I said, and their openness to be open with you. Those are always something that, those are some of the songs that really spoke to me. And through my own perspective, it was a reflection of myself almost to the T. Like, it really helped me going through my own journey. It really helped me dive deeper into my own vulnerabilities, more through the art. But even furthermore, it was a call to action by whoever was listening to heal, to save themselves, that nobody's coming to save you. Kendrick can't save you. J. Cole can't save you. Martin Luther King can't save you. Malcolm can't save you. Trump can't save you. Jesus can't save you, etc. It speaks to reclaiming your own personal power, to reclaim yourself, reclaim the love, the compassion, the vulnerability inside of yourself.